Crazy Sheba Lady here. I've been busy lately finishing up some schooling and working on a polar bear full suit, and that can take up a bit of time as you can imagine. So today I thought I'd show you how I make my full suits from start to finish. This is a rough process of how someone might go about making a suit, and the methods will differ. On a second note, for those of you who commission, please keep in mind that it can take a while to get the final product. You will see in this video why it takes so long and what the maker goes through to make your suit. So if you don't give anyone a hard time about the cost they are asking for to make it, or the amount of time it takes to make the suit, or mask, or partial, or whatever you have going on, it will make things a lot easier for you and the maker. The hardworking suit makers will appreciate it that much more. Okay, enough talk. Let's get to work.
Start by laying out your body pattern on your material. Then pin, trace, and cut. Repeat the same steps with all of your other patterns. Next is the hood. Then the hands, left and right. Finally, the tip. Of course, we have Adonis here to help as well. Pin all your pieces together, and sew. Next up, I take in the arm patterns to fit a little more snugly. Then I pin and sew. Attach it to the bodysuit using pins, and take out a small triangular piece for the underarm. That gives the arm a bit more movement. Then, sew the arms into place. At the same time, I attach the zippers into the hood and bodysuit. There's a small ring in place to help the wearer when zipping up the suit. Next, the upper thigh pattern for padding. First, the top part of the padding. The bottom half. Now pin, sew, and stuff. These are my first attempt with making this type of padding that is not carved out of foam, so it's not the best, but it'll do. Practice makes perfect! Now for the calf section of the padding. Next up, the ears. Okay, so I spaced and didn't record this part of the process. But for those who are interested, this link will show how I made a pair of ears using the same method. I use a pre-made pattern to trace and cut them out, then use some wire to help them keep their shape. Finally, the casting of the head. I mix equal parts of each material and mix them together thoroughly. Then I add a small amount of powdered thickening agent. This helps to strengthen this particular mask. Also, because the space is so large, it saves on the amount of resin being used and helps it to keep it lightweight. Now I carefully slush cast the mold and let each layer dry properly before moving on to the next layer. This is what it looks like so far in the process. Still needs a few more layers, but it's getting there. Here's the mold, cast and pulled, and ready for some much needed cleaning up. The side got a little jacked up during the casting, but nothing a little sanding can't fix. Can't forget about the ever important hinges! Here's the head with the eyes, nose, and mouth drilled out, and ready for some sanding and cleanup. The hinges have already been measured, and the screw holes have been drilled into place. Scented product, nice and smooth, and of course, the tear ducts. Now with the hinges in place, it's time to attach the springs, lips, and nose. Made eyes, ready for installing. The nose has been installed, as well as the lips. Next, it's time to make a mold of this bad boy, and get him ready for furring. Of plastic wrap, some duct tape, a pair of scissors, and voila! Now I use the patterns and trace them onto the fur material and cut them out, just like before. Sew them all together. Here are the eyes and lips all painted up, along with the teeth and tongue installed into place with a bit of padding. course, the vision holes need a bit of mesh put into place. That's better. To stay on the wearer's head. I don't think we want it to fall off during a performance. Attach the fur to the base with some hot glue. Please be careful not to burn yourself. It kind of hurts. After that, I give the face a clean shave.
Watch this. Now hop tower. Quick one, place your honor here.
Apparently he's British. Now that that's done, it's time to foam the feet. I cut out the toe patterns and round off the edges for a clean look. Attach them to the shoe, tape up the pattern, and cut them out. course, every pair of bear feet needs some big bear claws. The bottoms have been sprayed with a waterproof coating to keep them a little more durable for wearing outside. And here we have it, the finished product of an ice bear in the wild.